Is it possible to come back to the first time CEO? It's terrible, the economy cannot afford the pressure.
This is the reason why we need to look into life and livelihood, the balance between health and economy. We need to look into how we can strike the right balance. It's not easy for us. It's certainly a challenge for us to strike the right balance between the two. So now we have to look into the data, whether we can contain the infection, and then we have to also look into the economy. So if you look into the three criteria from WHO, criteria number one, looking of before they declare a state of emergency, we have to look into the infectivity, the rate of the spread. Criteria number two is the virulence, the fatality. If the fatality is very high and they spread very fast, these are the two criteria before they announce. The third criteria will be the economic impact. So they have to look into the three areas before a declaration of a state of emergency. This is also very important for us to balance in terms of life and livelihood, health and economy. So we need to look into the economy, we need to look into the health aspect. Can we contain the infection? At the moment, we think that we can, because we can use our whatever we have done in March and April and to use the public health intervention to contain the infection. So we also need the collaboration and cooperation of each and every individual in our country to comply to the SOP. By complying the SOP, you are breaking the chain of infection. If there's no urgency, please stay at home. If you need to go out of your home, please comply the SOP, put on a mask, and then practice physical distancing. I think it's a simple message, but not easy to practice. Because of the fatigue, we understand the fatigue. But remember, we cannot let down our guts. If we have the fatigue, and let down our guts, the virus will continue to spread. There's no fatigue for the virus, but there's fatigue for humans like us. So I hope that we can comply to the SOP.